Hey everyone, it's Michael again. I'm so glad to see you. Are you getting better at recovering data? I bet you are. And this is a first episode of a new series. You ask, we answer. We want to make something that is going to be helpful to you, so we decided that we can respond to all of your questions about us, about our industry, and about Recoverit in particular. Do you have a technical question about Recoverit, or maybe you're wondering about more tips and tricks, or you want to get to know our team better, or you want to know about our working environment? We're going to use this series to respond to anything you want to ask us. So be more active and ask all your questions in the comments right below every single video that we post. And from time to time, we're going to pick the most common questions and pack them into such episodes. So let's go ahead, kicking off our first episode with some frequently asked questions about data recovery. Is it safe to use a recovery software? Well, gymers have a perfect answer to this question. They would say jein, which is a mixture of ja and nein, which translated means yes and no at the same time. And we would always come up with this question before using a data recovery software for the first time. That's human nature. We don't trust things that we don't know. Makes perfect sense. But I have to say that data recovery softwares are generally safe. They don't harm your system or your device, and data recovery software cannot steal privacy data from your PC, phone, or install spyware on it if it comes from a legit company. All that these softwares are doing are to recover the files which are physically still residing somewhere on your drives. Nowadays, there are many data recovery softwares available online, and each one of them, one way or another, claims to be the best. The reputable ones, or those from the big companies, will recover data exclusively and professionally, like Recoverit. But there also are some softwares from unknown or shady developers which would be interested in doing more than just recovering your data. How long does it take to recover data? Really depends. If you contact professionals, let's say a data recovery professional company, it might take a few days, maybe a week, maybe more than that. The amount of time a recovery would take is varying depending on the problem. If you use a professional data recovery software, it's gonna take less time. For instance, if you just scan a disk with 2 GB of data, it just needs a few minutes. But it also depends on many factors such as the disk health status, the type of the disk, because we know that generally hard disk drives are slower than solid state drives, and other contributing factors would be the capacity, the interface type, the file size, the computer performance, and so on. Recoverit often helps users to recover data in just a few minutes. How much does it cost to recover data? Well, very often, the files that we desperately need to recover are priceless. And generally, the price could vary between $0, which would be the price for freeware solutions, up until a few $1,000s. And we can divide the recovery solutions into two major groups. The first one would be a professional data recovery solution or a company. And the second option is to use a professional data recovery software. First, we know that sometimes it is hard to find a good recovery center, especially if we need a trusted one. According to various surveys about the most popular data recovery services in the United States, pricing on typical hard drive recovery can take between $100 and $1,500, sometimes even more. By contrast, the investment in a data recovery software costs just a fraction of that price. Some reputable data recovery software brands, such as Recoverit, provide customers with the best experience to recover data, more importantly, spending the least money. The free version of Recoverit can recover up to 100 megabytes data for free, and you can upgrade for a premium version, which is going to cost you only $35.95 to recover unlimited amount of data. How does the data recovery work? Well, I'll try to keep things simple here. Essentially, when files get deleted or the file system gets corrupted, that doesn't necessarily mean that your files are physically gone. They might still reside on the drive, and the work that the data recovery softwares do is to find this data and recover it bit by bit. The chances for a successful result depend greatly on the specific data loss situation, but you should keep in mind that no information is recoverable if it is being overwritten multiple times. For that reason, nothing should be written to the storage until the last file that you want is being rescued. Commonly, data recovery process is based on a storage scan, which is serving to find the specific information like deleted files or corrupted file systems, and then assembling the structures of the damaged file system together and bringing your files back to life. What causes the need for data recovery? Well, very often the reasons can be many, and even more often, unpredictable. Well, a common thing could be a human error, like you do something, you accidentally delete the file, and in 3 weeks from now, you figure out, oh, I actually needed this. Or it could be accidental format, accidental repartitioning, and so on. Could be a result of a nasty computer virus or a natural disaster, fire, flood, sometimes just accidental physical damage, unintended, and so on. Anyhow, most of the time the data is not permanently lost, it's just not accessible for you. And in these situations, solutions like Recoverit can help you to recover your files. And so, guys and girls, that was all about the first episode from our Recoverit Frequently Asked Questions series. And I sincerely hope it was useful to you, first of all, to know how data recovery works, and secondly, to know better how to avoid getting into such trouble situations. And let me know which are going to be your further questions. And the most popular out of these, we're going to pack together, and we're going to talk about them in our next episode. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe in order to be better educated about data recovery. My name is Michael, and I'm looking forward to see you in the next episode.